Take a break. Chew Wrigley's Spearmint Gum.
The cool, refreshing feeling of Wrigley's Spearmint Gum puts a little lift in everything you do. That good, smooth chewing, that crisp, clean taste. That Wrigley's Spearmint pickup is going for you.
Wrigley's Spearmint Gum really keeps you humming. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum keeps you humming along. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum really keeps you humming. Wrigley's Spearmint Gum keeps you humming.
Martha Quinn, and you're watching MTV Music Television. All day, all night, all video music.
Thank you. 170 Foster City Boulevard, the second floor. That is the exit sign at the end. 7 11 7. Who is that sexy guy?
I'm with Fox and Karskaden. This is the blanket that I'm sure Barbara's kid peed on.
Is that what you think really happened?
Yeah. And these are my drawings. I'll get the light switch real quick. And those are my drawings right there that I'm very proud of. And then in here is the kitchen. And this is California Magazine, California Living. The wheels have turned on the 1984 automobiles. And to quote the San Francisco Chronicle, Chrysler Laser Dodge Daytona, cars that have everything and are priced for every man. These two are maybe the best things Iacocca has done outside of rescuing the Statue of Liberty. They're powered by 2.2-liter multi-port fuel-injected engines, are turbocharged, have close-ratio 5-speed gearboxes. The seats have lumbar supports courtesy of an old-fashioned pharmacist bulb. The Dodge comes with an air dam and Mark Cross interior. Base price is $10,400. Genuine Oh My God cars. Brought to you by Chrysler, an American revolution.
That's right.
It's good to use the batteries. The capacitor gets charged. Welcome to Drawing with Neil, a weekly show brought to you to help you further expand your capability to perceive the world around you and to participate in a moment and a time when you are able to participate only as an artist. Sounds great. All I want to show are these are my two latest drawings. And this particular group here is the laser. This is the first initial sketch. This is done on Vincent Vellum. And this is the Kennedy limousine. And it's in X100 1961 dress, which means that the front grille is the original grille that the car was designed by Ford Motor Company to have. They changed it in 62, and it's in a museum now, and it still has the same grille. That's the grille that was on the car when Kennedy was shot. But this is a Vincent Vellum sketch, which will be further developed, and I'm going to work on putting that on videotape. God, this is the best one. Underneath, you can see that the paper is very durable. You can't be afraid of it. I mean, if you are, then you can't draw because the paper becomes too. There's another version of the car right there. That's, I think, a better detailing of the front grille design. And it began with this base sketch, which was colored, and I like that one as well, too. You can see that. And what will be interesting is to maybe sit down at the table, put the camera on the tripod, and watch the progress of my drawing, doing the react to it, and I think that you would probably want to get drunk too if you had had that information expressed to you. And all I can say is that I am not equipped as a person to deal with the fact that you are visited and frequented, and who's going to believe me, visited and frequented by people from another planet who are actually aware of what your purpose on this sphere, this planet is. And now I'm a participant and I want nothing to do with it. Yet they want to talk to me because of your association. So all I can say is that I'm going to drink this. In fact, I think I'm going to go out and find some vodka. Excuse me. You know, I think the fact that you're so able to record and document this for their purposes, the whole reason you have this stuff is for their purposes. If I were you, I would stop recording it right now, because they're coming back in and they're not going to allow you to take a picture of them. I think that, Mark, what you have to do is understand that I don't want you to be videotaping this right now. Turn it off right now.
A very long. He knows you're here. Got to think of a way for you to escape the realm of Foster City. At least I can give you a clear launch pad.
Is to save mankind from the tyranny, from the destruction, from the capability of overwhelming individuals that these creatures from your planet have created. Now I must live with the fact that on their journey, I tell them when to leave. And they're all going back to the land that I had discovered for them. And that victim, that innocent victim, ceases to be an individual from another planet, ceases to be a capacity that is greater than what I can say in this life, for I put them in their place. Their home is in the planet refrigerator. And your friend is just... Now, And from here on out, your other friends will have their fate determined by when we will allow them to escape. But until then, they'll reside, be comfortable, and enjoy existence.
Across the meridian.
Uh-huh.
Across the street. In the crosswalk, and this motorcycle comes up with this mall sitting on the back.
Yeah.
And he's like trying to push Mark out of the way. And Mark stops and looks at him and says, you know, I just had breakfast, but I could get to work up to be hungry again, asshole. The guy stops his bike, gets off, and when he gets off, three big bikes come around the corner.
Uh-huh.
It's these guys' buddies, right? They pull up behind him to support him. And there's Mark standing in the middle of the street.
Yeah.
He says to himself, this is Herbert's little son, Marky, just seen drawing his last breath.
Uh-huh.
When these big brutes get on the bike and start walking towards him. And he looks at them, and they look at him, and he puts to his feet, he says, go ahead, make my day. And everybody dies on that. They just so cracked up. He cracked up, they cracked up, and he got away with his skin. Man. Go ahead. Meet my day. He comes walking to my sister's house still shaking. What are we doing? What's going on with you?
Thank you. Could you do me a favor?
Yeah.
If you don't mind, could you bring me the hair dryer from the bathroom in there? Is it on the speaker? Thank you. interesting. They just showed someone in a wheelchair wearing 501s.
Bill Collins on his own, a double concert bill. Tonight, 11 o'clock Eastern, 10 Central, on MTV Music Television.
I gotta be careful with these razors around. To the video store and rent a couple movies?
Yeah.
You know what I want to see? There's a Kurt Vonnegut movie that I've always wanted to see, not Catch 22. Although that would be a bizarre movie to see.
I haven't seen it when I read it.
Oh.
Vonnegut, Slaughterhouse 5?
That's it. Slaughterhouse 5. I've always wanted to see that.
I'll go over.
I'll take a ride with you.
All right. We'll each rent one. I should have put a tablespoon of flour in the cheesecake.
Why?
It needs it.
This is gonna be dynamite. Do you know what I'm doing right now? I'm going to put the last coat of the dark blue on there. See this surface?
Yeah.
See how this is. See how clever a boy I've been?
Oh, uh-huh. What are you, white?
Yeah, I kept the reflections in there.
Mm-hmm.
Tina. Do it, Tina.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
You like the hairdo?
No, I don't.
Is that horrible?
Shit, it looks like a dust mopper. I love it. She can do it. I mean, I'm surprised by it, but only Tina Turner can carry it off.
She can carry it off. I still think it's a bit much. Could be a little less. Yeah, a little less.
She's, I guess she's kind of like the queen.
She is.
Is she and Ike Turner split up?
Yes.
Did they get a divorce?
Not sure if the divorce happened, but yeah, they are.
Thank you. almost sounds like Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Did you see that movie?
Oh, a number of times, yeah.
Yeah. See it with the dark blue finally on there? Yes.
Oh, that's exciting.
It looks shiny.
Yeah.
Wait till I get the door cuts in there. That's how you show the door cuts. And then when I go back with the white.
This is neat.
Oh,
that's your pencil.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Did you see just to show like reflection and shininess?
Yeah.
Painting graffiti on the wall about Ford,
mm-hmm.
and they're not letting Ford use it anymore because they see that it contributes to graffiti. Or to the habit of writing on walls.
Thank you. is than that.
Called Should I?
The remote control and the laser.
Go desperate, I don't need you beside me no more.
Move back.
Come on, happiness.
Grandma and Amy.
Oh no, that fucking vet just hit our laser. That's a nice car. Smash it. Hills Creek, isn't it lovely?
The travelogue.
And another lovely picture of Hills Creek State Park and Lake. Isn't that nice, boys and girls? Here.
No, I don't want to break them. I mean, they can bump, but don't break them. Now, go.
Did you see it? I get the laser.
Oh, wait, they gotta
hit
up here. They gotta hit up here.
Here.
Now. It's a car shot.
That's gonna be really boring. I think the dog is more exciting. Run over Lassie. Lassie was killed last night. Call the pet doctors.
And he arrives in a Corvette.
Our next segments will be Indians making love. Which one's the boy? Which one's the squaw? Look, boys and girls.
Don't. That's not fair to Lorraine's Indians.
That's rude.
How rude?
She's dead. Oh, her eyes open. Look, boys and girls, her eyes open and close. You broke it! Look, she's dancing. Let's make him dance.
Look what I caught hunting.
Her head shakes. Here comes the dog. Oof! Oof! Get her. Get her.
Lorraine will die if she sees this.
She will. She'll say, my poor Indian friends. Vacuum cleaner, what is it? Did you make that thing?
Yes.
What is it? What does it do? Is it decoration?
Come on,
it's certainly pretty.
That would be a nice prop, huh?
Nice what?
Prop.
Prop? For what?
Yeah.
What is it, Neil, really? What is it?
It's a sander.
For what, plastics?
Uh-huh.
Does it work?
Mm-hmm.
Does it vibrate?
No, it's very practical.
It's hand? By hand?
Mm-hmm.
What's this all for?
That's for plugging it into the pneumatic air jack.
Does that suck with sawdust or what?
Mm-hmm.
We dealt with Dennis. He's gay. He's such a dirty boy.
Why, what'd he do?
He's just weird. He's giving Diana a hard time about her checks. So was I, actually. She wanted the Mood collection.
I don't want to talk to anyone.
Just wondering why it was gone?
Nope.
Of course not.
My blackmail tapes.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you guys feel about the vote for the San Francisco song that there's so much controversy about? Do you think they should leave it that mushy, I left my heart in San Francisco, or do you think they should change it to San Francisco from the...
The loveliness of Paris seems somehow oddly gay. The glory that was Rome is of another day. I've been terribly alone and forgotten in Manhattan. your Golden Gate, fucking Bollywood. I don't know what. San Francisco, fucking the hemorrhoids. Got it.
Now you tell me what's more relevant.
I think it should be changed to San Francisco. The only people who enjoy I Left My Heart in San Francisco are people sitting in a Detroit bar.
Bullshit. I lived here all my life and I've heard San Francisco or I Left My Heart. And nothing tears your heart apart more than, like for me and me in 1969, you know, this singer came on in this club that we were at with my grandma in Maine.
The loveliness of Paris seems somehow oddly gay. The glory that was Rome.
Apparently your vote is for I Left My Heart in San
Francisco. Is of another day. I've been terribly alone and for cutting in Manhattan. I'm going home to my city by the bay.
You know, there is no way. I understand what Jeanette McDonald and all those other San Francisco, open your golden gate, I have a hemorrhoid that can wait. You know, I understand what they're saying about San Francisco, but...
But that song has so much up to it and so much oomph. Whereas...
My dear...
I Left My Heart in San Francisco, so, you know, wishy-washy and...
My and dear and my good man, let me sing you I Left My Heart in San Francisco.
But you just
the
did.
Love of Paris seems somehow oddly gay. The glory that was Rome is of another day. I've been terribly alone and forgotten in Manhattan. I'm going home to my city by the bay. I left my heart in
something
San
about
Francisco.
Cable cars climbing to the halfway.
Yeah, you only know the one
just
verse here.
Is
verse.
I left my heart.
See, but you're saying you left it in San, meaning you're not in San Francisco at the time you're singing the song.
San Francisco. High on a hill. It costs.
Can I be saved from this? This is good.
I think we should watch Johnny Carson.
Yeah, let's do something different for a little while.
Well,
can I? How do I turn this off?
Terribly, I haven't finished my song.
Just push what?
That one.
No matter.